If you're applying to business school, I probably don't need to tell you that your essays and personal statements are key components of your application. In onTrack by mbaMission, an on-demand, highly personalized admissions course, I teach you how to effectively communicate to the admissions committee not just where you've been, but where you're going. Here's a preview of a lesson from our personal statements module in which I discuss how to write about your short-term career goals. Take a look. When MBA programs ask you to write about your short and long-term post-MBA goals, they quite ironically know that your actual goals are likely to change while you're in their program. After all, you're coming to business school to learn about yourself and to contemplate your future. But as many admissions officers have told me over the years, they would prefer that you at least have clear short-term goals that could change rather than no short-term goals at all. The latter obviously reveals a complete lack of direction and therefore no need for business school for you. Of course, admissions officers don't just want clear goals. You also need to share a short-term path that is plausible and exciting. In this video, I'll be talking exclusively about short-term goals. We'll have another lesson later on long-term goals. With respect to plausibility, you need to share goals that you can achieve. For example, if you were the operations analyst in the essay you just read, you couldn't just say that you want to go into biotech venture capital. There's no obvious path between the two careers. Admissions officers will read those goals and determine that no matter how awesome you are as an applicant, their program just won't be able to get you there. Unclear or improbable goals are a huge reason many applicants get dinged. Let's ensure that is not you. So, do your homework. If you haven't already, check out our post-MBA goals module for a deep dive into your post-MBA career options and how to narrow your choices and determine which fit you. You need to ensure that a path from where you are to where you want to go exists. Returning to our operations analyst, she can discuss how she wants to go back to her manufacturing firm, but she must share how she'll have greater responsibility post-MBA. Otherwise, again, why does she need that MBA? She can also discuss how she wants to change careers and leverage her analytical skills to move into consulting. She can share how she wants to join a rotational management program at a Fortune 100 firm. She can write about how she wants to join an AI startup focused on early detection of bottlenecks in manufacturing processes, or go into supply chain consulting. All of these paths are plausible for her. Super. Rest assured, admissions officers have no preference for one path over any other. They just want to learn that you're passionate about a path and that it will lead you to exciting post-MBA vistas. These vistas don't need to be positions no one has ever heard of before. We said earlier that your short-term path needs to be both plausible and exciting. The exciting aspect is not revealed through buzzwords, but is revealed by your expected growth and purpose. If our operations analyst wanted to pursue any of the paths we just mentioned, she would need to stretch herself to get there. These are exciting stretches, but they're not impossible. Let's review an alternative example for this applicant, the operations analyst. What do you think of the following? As an operations analyst, I led our firm's data-driven transition to lean manufacturing. I'm now ready to apply my analytical skills post-MBA as a consultant at Bain, McKinsey, or BCG. Global firms that make data-driven decisions. Plausible? Possibly. Exciting? Not really. The applicant is so brief that she eliminates any spirit or excitement. We know the role she wants, but we don't know why she thinks she can succeed in it, and we don't know why the role is a fit for her. Let's look at her actual essay example again, reading from the start of her goals. Today, SRC is a completely new company, wielding operations to complete orders faster, reduce costs, and gain share. I've seen how powerfully analytics can transform business and want to apply this approach to solve problems for larger global companies. I aspire to join a consulting firm such as Bain or McKinsey because of the breadth of assignments available and the mentorship associates receive, plus the opportunity to significantly expand my professional and personal horizons. In this second example, we have a goal statement that thoughtfully connects the applicant's existing skills and future experience. She connects her data-driven problem-solving experience with the data-driven work that a consultant must navigate and shows that how the job sets her up for professional and personal growth through global experience. The latter is well explained, purposeful. It's exciting for her. Plausible, exciting goals connected to skills and experience. If you write like that, just like our operations analyst, you'll be on your way. Next up, you'll see your short-term career goals that you fleshed out earlier in the course. Now that you've learned a bit more, do they still make sense? Are they plausible? Exciting? If not, make some changes, and then we'll talk about your long-term goals. There's so much to learn about how to craft compelling personal statements, and we dig into all of it and analyze full-length written samples in the rest of our personal statement module. And of course, this is just one piece of the admissions puzzle. In onTrack, I'll guide you through the entire application process, from connecting with your target programs to crafting a strong resume to managing your recommenders and so much more. We start by providing you with a personalized curriculum based on your profile. If you're ready to explore onTrack, tap the link to complete our introductory questionnaire and receive your customized learning path. And best of luck to you with your applications.